start the class on your self-work on the principles of effective communication. What are the skills you have cultivated so far? What are the good habits you are going to cultivate? You need to cultivate, and what is your learning objective from the lesson? The principles of effective communication, and why is it important in any work, in any organization, at any workplace? I have some students who raised their hands. So let us start with Monica.
Yes.
The rest of you, please keep your microphone muted.
Good morning, ma'am, and everyone. I am Monica. Today I am present here to throw some light on the principles of effective communication. Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to another effectively. Business managers with good verbal, non-verbal, and written communication will help facilitate the sharing of information between people within a company. Now comes to the principles of effective communication. The first principle is principle of clarity. Clarity is a characteristic of a speech that communicates effectively. Clarity implies emphasizing on a specific message or goal at a time. Complete clarity of thoughts and ideas enhance the meaning of message. Clear message makes use of exact, appropriate, and concrete words. So the message should be clear, simple, and straightforward. The second principle is understanding. Understanding the receiver is the main aim of any communication. There you should follow two important principles. They are first to understand, then to be understood. And the second one is
understand.
Ma'am, if I present any presentation and some audience is looking for me for the information, then first I have to understand the points that I going to understood someone.
Going to understand someone.
Yeah, ma'am, going to understand someone. And the second one is we also consider what's receiver requirement, that is their custom, timing, environment, social climate, etc. The next principle is principle of completeness. This principle states that communication must be complete in all aspects. It should convey all facts required by the audience. The sender of the message must take into consideration the receiver mindset and convey the message accordingly. The next principle is principle of consistency. This principle states that communication should always be consistent with the policies, plans, programs, and objectives of the organization and not in conflict with them. If the message and communication are in conflict with the policies and programs, then there will be confusion in the minds of the subordinates and they may not implement them properly. So there should be no variance and no confusion. The next principle is principle of feedback. The principle of feedback is very important to make the communication effective. There should be a feedback information from the recipient to know whether he has understood the message in the same sense in which the sender has mean. The next principle is principle of time. Time principle states the communication should be done at proper time.
so that it helps in implementing plans, and any delay in communication may not serve any purpose. Now, at the end, I would like to conclude my words with: a good relationship starts with good communication. A great relationship also means good communication, in the sense that when differences arise, the partner can talk through their dilemma cooperatively. Differences doesn't become barriers, they become opportunities to find understanding and solution. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I am Nandini, and now I am going to throw some light on effective communication. So the communication is not only effective when we communicate in a way that is meaningful to the recipient. With the help of effective communication, two parties can exchange messages thoroughly without any misunderstanding. It allows members to work together without any worries about different backgrounds of hierarchy. With the help of effective communication, we can develop our self-esteem and confidence. Now, there are some principles on effective communication, like trustworthiness, clarity, proper medium, etc. So the first one is trustworthiness. It is necessary in the communication. It's not only affects the receiver, it affects your personality also. Without trust, no one can believe in your words. When the trust account is high, communication is easy, instant, and effective. Next one is clarity. Clarity refers to a specific message in our communication. Complete clarity improves the exact thoughts or ideas of message. Clarity implies emphasizing on a specific message or goal at a time, rather than trying to achieve too much at once. Next is principle of appropriate language. This is a very important term in communication, because without appropriate language, no one can value our word, and it also creates a question mark in our personality. Our language is the reflection of ourselves. A language is an exact reflection of the character and growth of its speakers. Next one is principle of consultation. The terms come consultation, a conference between two or more people to consider a particular question. The obvious benefit of such a move will be that the communication will be effective, because communication is to be done among people working at different levels. Next one is principle of feedback. This principle refers to the success of message. It means the receiver has understood or not. Feedback, when given well, should not alienate the receiver of the feedback, but should motivate them to perform better. Next one is principle of proper medium. Proper medium means face-to-face conversation by handheld device or video conferencing, etc. So this principle refers to, we have to choose the way of communication according to the importance of the message. Wrong medium can create misunderstanding. It is not only to have a clarity of ideas, consistency, and completeness, but also to make a proper choice of medium. Now, I would like to conclude my word with a quote. The quote is, the key to effective communication is to be invested instead of interested. Thank you.
Good morning, and everyone. Today I am here to present my views on principles of effective communication. Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to another effectively and efficiently. Whether we are business managers, we should have good verbal, non-verbal, and written communication skills, which help us to facilitate the sharing of information between people within a company for its commercial benefits. Now let us talk about what are the principles of effective communication. There are various principles: trustworthiness, second one is effective listening, third one is non-judgmental, fourth one is soft skills, fifth one is principle of clarity, sixth is principle of appropriate language, seventh is principle of attention, and eighth.
Are you sharing screen?
No, ma'am.
Your camera is off. Voice is coming, but your camera is off. Yeah, now it's okay.
Now it's okay.
Yeah. Start again. Maybe because of the, now it's okay.
Okay. Continue. Good morning, ma'am and everyone. Today I am here to present my views on principles of effective communication. First of all, let us know what is effective communication. Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to another effectively and efficiently. Whether we are business managers, we should have good verbal and non-verbal written communication skills, which help us to facilitate the sharing of information between people within a company for its commercial benefits. Now let us talk about some principles of effective communication. The first principle is trustworthiness. The second one is active listening. The third one is non-judgmental. Fourth is soft skills. Fifth is principle of clarity. Sixth is principle of appropriate language. Seventh is principle of attention, and eighth one is principle of consistency. Let us understand this one by one. First one is trustworthiness. Trustworthiness means when two people are communicating, there should be trust between them. Otherwise, they will not be able to listen them. They will not understand each other. The second one is active listening. It is said that if we have to be a good speaker, we should have a good listener. So active listening is very important. Yes, ma'am. The third one is non-judgmental. It means giving feedback, but only if asked. Don't be judgmental, because we don't even know what's going on in others' life. The fourth one is soft skills. Soft skills means the way we behave, the way we project ourselves. Soft skills also very important in effective communication. The fifth one is principle of clarity. When we talk to someone, it should be clear. We should do the point. It should be clear and concise. Otherwise, the other person will not be able to understand our point, our views. The sixth one is principle of appropriate language. Whom we are talking, it's very important. It means if we are talking to children, we are talking to adults, we are talking to college students, as per the situation, as per the time, the language should be appropriate. The seventh one is principle of attention. If we will not pay attention, we will not be able to understand someone else's communication, and we will not be able to get her views or his views. The eighth one is principle of consistency. Consistency means whatever habit we have about effective communication should be consistent. It is not that only 1 or 2 days we are talking, we are communicating in effective manner. It should be consistent. Now, I would like to conclude by saying that effective communication is very important, whether in our career or in our day-to-day life. It is very important. Thank you, ma'am.
All right, students who are online, be ready. And now Komal will be presenting.
Hello everyone, good morning. I want to make a presentation on the topic principles of effective communication. First we will discuss what is effective communication. The ability to convey information to another effectively and efficiently. Now, we discuss principles of effective communication. The first one is clarity in ideas. First of all, it should be clear in mind of the sender as to what he wants to say. The clearer the thought, the more effective is the communication. The second one is appropriate language. The communication should always be in a simple language. Technical words and words having various meanings should be used to the minimum. The third one is attention. It means merely transferring information is not communication, and it is important that the receiver should understand it. The fourth one is consistency. Communication system should maintain consistency in the objectives of the enterprise, its procedures and processes. The fifth one is adequacy. The information sent to the receiver should be sufficient and complete in every respect. The sixth one is proper time. The messages should reach the receiver wherever they are needed. Late messages are meaningless and the utility of communication is ended. The seventh is informality. Informal communication should also be given recognition in the organization. The eighth one is feedback. It is essential for the sender of the message that he should know about the success of the message. And the last one is flexibility. Communication should be able to absorb the changes in the organization. And the last, I want to improve myself in the adequacy. Thank you, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am. Hello.
Gaurav, you can start your presentation. Gaurav.
Ma'am, I will show
you. Ma'am.
Can you make me host?
Yeah, Gaurav, can you start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Why did you say anything? Gaurav, unmute yourself first.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, all of you. Today's topic for my presentation is effective communication. So let's start. What is communication? Communication is the act of giving, receiving, and sharing information in the words, other words, talking and writing and listening or reading. Good communication, listen carefully, speak or written clearly, and respect different opinions. strong communication skills can help kids interact both face to face and in the online world. Process of communication. The process of communication refers to the transmission or passage of information or message from the sender through a selected channel to the receiver, overcoming barriers that affect its space. First one, sender. The very foundation of communication process is led by the process who transmits or sends the message. Second one, encoding. Encoding is putting the targeted message into appropriate medium, which may verbal or non-verbal, depending upon the situation, time, space, and nature of the message to the send. Third one, channel. Channel refers to the way or mode the message flows or is transmitted through. The message is transmitted over a channel that links the sender with the receiver. Fourth one, receiver. Receiver is the process or group where the message is meant for. He may be a listener, a reader, or a viewer. Fifth one, decoding. Decoding refers to the interpreting or converting the message, send message into language. Fifth one, feedback. Feedback is the unlimited aspect of communication process. Now I would like to invite my friend Mahi to continue the further presentation.
अपने को म्यूट Thank you, Gaurav, for inviting me. So the topic is effective communication. Effective communication is defined as the communication between two or more persons in which the intended message is. Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to another effectively and efficiently. Even the business managers with good verbal, non-verbal, and written communication skill help facilitate the sharing of information between people within a company for its commercial benefit. Few points are properly encoded, delivered through appropriate channel, received and properly decoded and understood by the recipient. Now the benefits of the effective communication. So the benefits of the effective communication, first one is building trust. Effective communication fosters trust with others, your ability to listen attentively and embrace different points of views help other trust that you are making optimal decision for everyone in the group. Second one, preventing or resolving problems. The ability to communicate effectively plays a large role in resolving conflicts and preventing potential ones from arising. Third one, providing clarity and direction. With effective communication skills, you are able to deliver clear expectations and objectives for your team. Fourth, creates better relationship. Good communication also improves relationship both with employees and in your personal life with friends and family members. Now come to the point, principles of effective communication. So the first principle of effective communication is principle of clarity. The beginning of all communication is a message. Always keep the following in mind when you deliver any message. First one, clear, simple and straight, concise, to the point, understanding from the audience. Now, the principle of consistency. The message to be communicated should be consistent with the plans, policies, programs and goals of the enterprise. No variance, no conclusion. Third point, principle of completeness. The message to be communicated must be adequate and complete. Otherwise, it would be misunderstood by the receiver. Venue, time, and the subject should be the part of the message. Always think of who, what, where, when, and how. Fourth, principle of feedback. Communication should be always a two-way process and should provide opportunities for suggestion, criticism, and confirmation of action required of the receiver. Having a question and answer session is good for two-way communication. Now, the point is, fourth point is principle of feedback. So always take the feedback from the others if necessary. And the last one is principle of time. The information should be communicated at the right time. Always pay attention to the length of the communication. When to communicate is also a critical factor for the success of communication. So the thought is, if you communicate, you can get by, but if you communicate skillfully, you can work miracles. Thank you everyone for listening to us.
Yeah, very well spoken, Mahi, and a presentation which was compact and concise and complete. So you're including, and now you are talking effectively, and it feels yes, with regular presentations on any technical issues concern, the self-work works wonders. If it's in your mind to communicate in a proper way, first it is the ideation, you ideate, you think that yes, I'm going to speak in a way people will be willing to listen to me. So if you are ready, if you are willing, if you are able, then nothing is stopping you and you can be the unstoppable. So effective communication is all about choosing the right words at the right time for the right people. Yes, next we have Priya Singh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. 2 minutes, ma'am. Network is ma'am. Bol rahe hain. Excuse me, ma'am. Okay.
Priya, please switch on your camera.
Good morning, ma'am. My name is Priya, and I'm going to share my views on effective communication. Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to another effectively and efficiently. Now comes on principle of effective communication. First one is have a goal. First, you need to determine what you want your audience to do or get out of your communication. Second is listen. If you never listen to what your audience is saying or give them a chance to engage, you will struggle to effectively connect with them. Third is stay organized. When starting out, create a cohesive, high-level outline that includes your goals, your main point to get across the main ways you are going to illustrate them for your audience. Fourth is be persuasive. This is the whole reason you are communicating, so do it well. Different people are persuaded differently. Fifth is be clear. Keep your writing clear and concise. Keep it as short as possible, avoiding long words when a short one will do. And generally keep your sentences below 30 words. Sixth is visuals are important. When communicating with an audience, varieties can go a long way. Visuals can also help you appeal to your audience emotion sides. Seventh is use stories. Another way to connect with your audience and communicate your ideas is with relevant, illustrative stories. Eighth is less is more. Your audience is likely busy, so don't waste your or their time with irrelevant tidbits, repeated information or details that you may be related but don't help you with the main communication goal. Thank you.
What do you understand by the term less is more?
मैम कम से कम मतलब कि ज्यादा टाइम वेस्ट नहीं करना है ऑडियंस का और खुद का भी कम से कम
वर्ड्स कम से कम शब्दों में अधिक से अधिक मैसेज. This is what technical communication is all about. You do not need a lot of sentences and phrases and paragraphs to make yourself understood. Kam se kam shabdon mein. For example, if you ask me to tell a story of Merchant of Venice, which is quite a thick novel, a very large novel, and if I want to give this, if I want to summarize, I will tell you the story in a few sentences only. And a few sentences will be complete. That will be complete. You will be listening to a complete story in a couple of sentences only. Less is more. But why? Because people are busy. People are constantly into conversation, thinking, intrapersonal, interpersonal. It is happening all the time. So people do not have time to listen to more and more and more. If you will give 10 instructions, they will maybe remember 2 or 3. So less is more. Right? Hi, yes. Yes, Pradeep Prakash. Pratha, are you there? People who are online, with the camera switched off, do you think you will be marked present today? Sagar. Yes, Pradeep Prakash, start.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, start.
Yes, ma'am. Rookie.
Yes, hello.
Rookie, 2 minutes, ma'am.
What happened? Start, Pratay. Sound is given. Pratay, unmute yourself first. Hello.
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yeah, you're audible.
Thank you, ma'am. First of all, good morning, ma'am, and good morning everyone who is listening to me. And now the presentation of effective communication, which is presented by Pratya Prakash and given by the Sanjana, ma'am. Now, what is effective communication? Effective communication is defined as the ability to convey information to the another effectively and efficiently. Now, efficiently communicating and ensure that you can only convey your message to someone, but also let them know about your feeling and emotion, whether it is amongst family member, friends, or office colleagues. Effective communication and helps individual get through the task or life with the case of ease. Now the points are, the principles of effective communications are.
Hello.
Sixth is principle of effective. Seventh principle is principle of
active. So network issues, maybe you can give it in the next class.
That's all. Thank you.
No issues.
Sorry, Kasan.
All those who have given the presentation, they will be given marks. And this was for the whole class. Maybe the next class. Do it in the next class. And as of Friday activity, you decide whether it's going to be any exam or it's going to be. Okay, I don't know. I'm telling you, is it good? If you want me to handle, I will handle, no problem. But I gave you responsibilities. Agar tum log chahte ho ki hum take up kare activities, so I can do it. But I gave you the chance to be the leader. But then, okay.